That was a terrible layout. You once lived with 14 cats. Oh, you're on a farm. That doesn't count. That's different. You need 14 cats to keep out all the mice and like snakes and everything else. Still trying to figure out how I can have my setup. Since I have this mic now, once I can kill whatever noise is coming from my computer, then I just need to be able to like hear sound without wearing these on my head, and then we're good. This was a really fast stage too. Oh yeah, finding them deceased in random places would suck. Is there really no ship piece? Okay. Now that I'm actually trying to like actually get a real run, I'm gonna get terrible layouts. Unfall's good though. If I have good presence, it's worth going. Decoy's not bad. Rose bushes are okay. Not really good though. It's like things to survive late game, not things to necessarily help the early game. I should have grabbed that buck though. Are we all better now? Not quite. I still have to be screened yearly for throat cancer. I'm still having to do a lot of speech therapy to get my voice back to where it was. And so it's not perfect. I can't sing in the same key that I used to be able to. So singing's like been really tough for me, which really sucks because I love to sing. Like, I love singing. So, but other than that, it's doing a lot better for sure. The new job is going amazingly. How's the two wives and four kids you don't even know you had? Apparently they're doing amazing and growing up quite well, and I haven't had to pay like a dime for them, so it's going great. Going great. Thought you just had inflammation. No, there's a thing on my throat, and so they want to check it every year, make sure nothing comes of it. Hashtag deadbeat dad. Oh, that's funny. No, the new job is really good. Like, it's not the end game job that I want, but it's the starting job that I need. And it's a starting job that's good because it puts me in a spot to do a lot of the things that I want to do without having to be like super mega level entry. So I'm in a spot where I can make a lot of waves. Like one of the things we're doing is a hackathon with one of the women coding groups in the area. And I just hooked us up with a nonprofit who's wanting to work with us to help come up with a social good idea. So I'm reaching out to venture capitalists to see if they want to join in on it and see what all happens. That way, if there's like a really good idea that they want to fund to actually make it work, then they can. So not only does that help out the school, but it also helps out like actual society. So I'm in a spot to do a lot of things, and I'm still trying to fill out what I want to do, but my boss, both of my bosses support it, so it's really cool. Because the boss, the dean of the campus who hired me, he's just like, oh my gosh. He's just like, yeah, just kind of do what you want. Like, act first, ask forgiveness later. Because the campus is still new in the area, so there's no like set kind of thing. So he just wants me to get out and see what I can make happen, which is awesome. And so my other boss, he likes it because he kind of has these ideas. Or I'll mention an idea and he'll be like, man, that sounds impossible. And I'm like, that's all right, I'll make it happen. Like this one with the hackathon, like he didn't think we'd get anyone to come with us. And I was like, no, I'll make it happen. I told him that on Thursday and I found a group on Friday and they've never been able to do it before. And so, same with like me working with ISSA, which if you're into cybersecurity, you know who they are. And I was able to have something happen with them. So I get to meet the VP of the whole organization for lunch. So I can make some things happen. It's really cool. It's really, really awesome. But basically the more that I do and the faster I can help us grow, the faster my boss, the dean, will shift me up to the position that I want. Which is basically working with the international section of higher education. And he's already told me that he wants me to be a huge part of that, just because, you know, I've already got a published document coming out for that. That was some of his background too. And he knows that I'm passionate about it, and a lot of my research went into that. And he's like, once we get into that, you know, we'll probably be having you fly out to other countries to try to get everything set up. I'm like, awesome. Yes, please help me do that. So, the job is really good. I just have to manage the financial side of it and make sure I just keep working as hard as I can and keep learning. So, why is there no ship piece yet? That's a reset. We can't go 5 stays just without a ship piece. That's a bad, that's really bad. Fund Cerulean Skylark's rise to Twitch Mountain. Well, that's always a goal. So, I just haven't been able to stay on top of that. But now that I'm back, I can get that going again. So, but everyone also keeps telling me I have to write a book about my life and where I've gotten to. I don't know if I want to write a book, but everyone keeps saying I need to write a book because my story is amazing. Oh, that's totally the throat thing there, Jer. I just saw the picture of that. That's funny. That's definitely the thing on my throat slowly taking over my brain. So, yeah, I don't know. We'll see how that goes. I might write a book. That's beautiful. That split though, save 27 seconds. If the rest of the run can go like this, I'll beat the world record. Give me the 30-minute God run and don't let me squander a game, please. Just like make it easy. I was gonna go for that present, but then I saw the elevator. Book confirmed. I don't know, we'll see. Like, cause then I gotta write about like my whole upbringing and everything, and I don't know if I wanna write about all that. It's kind of a mess. But I mean, it could become a New York bestseller. Maybe, I don't know. Did I have to move? I did not, no. I'm still in the same location. Keita, what is up, yo? How are you? It's good to see you as well. You could stream source your book. Stream source? What do you mean? What's stream source? Like stream me writing it? Nah. I definitely would do that off stream. Same old, that grind, that life grind. Extra life. Yeah, work again today for a while? Okay. It's like crowdsourcing, but you use streamers. But what does that do though? Oh, that's rip. These two presents just killed the run. Unless this is like a, that was an unfall. I'm stupid, I should have fell first. I should have, oh my gosh. Can I make that jump? Huh? Oh no, that's rip. That sucks. That was such a good start. Have you seen Trumbo? What's that? If you want to make friends with our enemy, AKA Canada. They're not my enemy. I might have to go to Canada for an event in September. So I'd be gone for like 2 days. I need to get my name fixed. I'm not gonna be called Dr. Jeggerd. That is not happening. I'm like 4 years out from having my doctoral degree anyway. And even once I have it, there's no way. I am not changing my name to Doctor. I don't want people to call me Doctor. It's not gonna be on my email signatures. It's not gonna be in my publications. Other people will refer to me as such, but I won't ever call my name Doctor. Oh man, that's a fast elevator. Too bad there wasn't a ship piece like right next to it. Dr. Jeggerd Esquire, the 3.5. I mean, if it was something like that, sure. Because that's so over the top, you kind of have to. Where are my ship pieces? This is bad. We're in Reset City. We've officially hit Reset City. Because I ruined the last start. I didn't ruin it, the game was a troll with the presents. That's what I'm gonna go with. See, like, my throat's already tired. But it's only 10 o'clock, so I'm gonna stream for a little longer. It's a movie about a writer who gets blacklisted during the Hollywood blacklist during the 1930s. But it's about a real person. Oh, okay. Yeah, I've never heard of it. I don't know a lot of movies though, so that should not come as a surprise to anyone. There's a point in the movie where he has a bunch of people writing for him, but they're all publishing under his name. Wow. So is that what I would be doing? Having people write about my life, but under my name? See, I don't want that because people can't write it accurately enough. You're just joking about it. Oh, I know you were. Is there no, oh, there's a ship piece. Okay. I need this present. So there's a ship piece on the next stage. Next, if I can get to ship piece 3 on pace, I'll keep this. Otherwise, it's reset. Because this time we're already really behind. Wow. Beautiful doorways. It was a dark and stormy night, oh gosh. Didn't like all the Goosebumps books start like that? It was a dark and stormy night. Okay, so we got here relatively decent enough. Ghost writing. Two blood moons rose over Mount Doom. A newborn's first cry could be heard across the Valley of Wonders. That baby's name was Jeggerd. Oh boy. After he got blacklisted, he wrote under a pen name and won 2 Academy Awards but couldn't claim them. Wow, that sucks. It was a dark and stormy night. I mean, I guess if I write all the misfortune that I had, it probably was a dark and stormy night. I think I was born in the evening. Yeah, it was the evening. The presents weren't that amazing anyway, so it's not a big deal. Okay, cool. I'm glad I wasted all that time on those presents when the elevator was like right there. It's really good. Really good. There's no ship piece here either. And stage 6 always is the troll stage. So this is probably a reset. So how has Twitch been since I've been gone? I mean, outside of Skystream. Like, has it gotten more dead? Like, is it dying? Is it thriving? Like, how has it been? Yeah, I've been away from Twitch, so I don't know. I'm curious what you all think the state of Twitch is currently. Okay, it's up there. I don't have flight. That's reset. The Filipino government uses hitmen to kill drug dealers. I mean, I guess that's one way to do it, right? Twitch is getting more popular, so are commercials. Interesting. According to BBC, Twitch bought Curse, the WoW add-on client group thing. People played No Man's Sky for 2 days, then they stopped. That's all that's happened. What up, Atomic Toasty? How you doing? Yeah, I hear that game is amazing the first day and becomes very meh, like, immediately after. Huh, they bought Curse. Interesting. More commercials, eh? Are the commercials better, at least? Yeah, 400 per dealer is not that expensive. Well, I mean, I guess for them, because 400 goes a long way in the Philippines. But still, for us, yeah, that's not much to take out a drug dealer, I guess. I mean, if it's cleaning up the streets, can we argue with the results, right? It's methods. I don't know. I've been out of the politics game for a little bit, so I'm not well-versed enough, but I don't know. That's an interesting debate, though. A moral debate, because I'm sure some people would be like, no, using hitmen to get rid of drug dealers is terrible. Whereas for me, it's like, well, I mean, there's worse things. They could still be rampant. So, I don't know. It's interesting to think about. Games are always like that. It's the same with the hype with Diablo 3. Well, Diablo 3 lasted for a little bit, though. For a little bit. I just hear No Man's Sky just got really repetitive really quick, and nobody was expecting that. And so they were kind of disappointed. I don't have a ship piece, do I? Nope. But that was a big roundabout to take. And no faith in the video game industry. Yeah, you can link the article if people want to see it. That's fine. You know the typical way to get articles to me. I definitely want to check it out. So everyone should play Marvel Puzzle Quest and then like attach it to Facebook and make sure you're my friend on Facebook. Because when I ride the bus, that's what I play. And so I want to be able to see y'all on there. I don't know what you do, but it's just like, here, send stuff to your friends. And it's like, well, I don't know anybody who plays this game. I just started playing this game because I didn't have internet. Yeah, everybody was super hyped up. Like, my immediate boss, he bought a PlayStation 4 because of that game. And that Metal Gear Solid 5, but like he jumped on the PS4 train very late. He saw that game and he was like, because he was going to buy a PS3, because I can get a PS3 and 30 games, or I can buy a PS4 and get No Man's Sky and like Metal Gear Solid 5, which I love Metal Gear and stuff. So he got the PS4 and now he's just like, bleh. Oh, what did they say was going to be in the game? But it wasn't in there, Atomic. I didn't hear that there was like features missing. I just heard that it got really repetitive. We finally found a ship piece, but we're on stage 5 and it's only 4 minutes in, so that's not bad. It's not necessarily good, though. Doesn't matter anymore though, you're about to go live somewhere. There's no internet, no running water, no electricity from the grid, and probably no phone in 6 days. Wow. Dang, you're just going out into the woods and roughing it forever? Factions and PvP. Massive ship battles. Oh. Yeah, I never even heard about that stuff. Ah, the stage sucks. Oh, just for the winter in Wisconsin. Okay. So you'll be back for a little bit. You'll be back after the winter time. That'll be fun, though. That'll be quite the experience. Oh, man. I wasn't expecting to get hit there. There's a Reddit. It'll be interesting to see what you learn from the experience, T-Rez. Like, not having anything. Because I didn't have internet for a couple of months. And so that was interesting for me. Because I was having to do my schoolwork either at work or at the library or, you know, wherever I could get Wi-Fi at. Where is this ship piece? Are you serious right now? It's either gonna suck really hard or be kinda cool. You have no reservations. It'll be interesting, definitely. People in Wisconsin are chill. I have one friend from Wisconsin. He was cool. So based on that one interaction, I can generalize that they're all awesome. Or at least decent enough. Hooking my cable modem back up, did I feel like a crack fiend? Actually, no, I didn't. It was actually kind of peaceful. It was stressful from a school standpoint, but in terms of like personal stuff, like I wanted to watch streams, of course. But outside of that, like it was kind of nice. That's too far away. If there's not a shit piece on the next stage, then I'm gonna have to reset again because we're just gonna be way too behind on time. Wow, that didn't help at all. Presents kind of suck. It's an unfall. So I know an unfall and I know a doorway. And I have a rocket skates. Okay, so. Alright. If there's a ship piece on the next stage, this is still runnable. I'm just gonna have to make up a whole lot of time. Anyone want to buy a 1984 Porsche 944? Need a gun and an ATV instead. Just turn your Porsche into a gun and an ATV. I'm sure you can convert the parts. Just melt down the doors into the gun casing. Or just mount a gun to the top of it. Okay, there's no ship piece here. I gotta hurry and find the elevator, or this is a moot point. Convert your Porsche to a car from The Mask. I haven't seen that movie in so long. One thing that I did while I didn't have the internet was I finally saw the Avengers Age of Ultron, because they were playing it in the park in my town, so I went and watched it. It was alright. I didn't care for the Hulk Black Widow romance thing. Oh, $5, that's good. Oh no. Isn't Ultron the best? I mean, his character was cool. His design, it was all right. Yeah, it was an okay movie. I mean, they had to change the origins up because of rights to characters and stuff. But, like, you know, Robert Downey Jr. is still, he's made for Iron Man. Like, I don't think there's anyone who can play Tony Stark and Iron Man better than him. I like the guy. I don't know who he is, what his name is, but the guy who plays for Bruce Banner, I like him. So I had no problems with that. Everyone else kind of throwaway. The guy who played for Ultron did well. The voice actor, anyway. So. I really wish they would have just kept Quicksilver and Scarlet Witch out of the movie. Like, if you can't have them be mutants because Fox owns the rights to mutants, don't put them in the movie. Just don't. Like, the way they changed their origin, I just thought was kind of stupid. Yeah, they altered Ant-Man a lot too, which was kind of lame. Mark Ruffalo, is that who played him? I don't know names of people very well. Gonna have to kill and skin a bear with your bare hands. You just grow bear hands and then you can fight bears. Remember when Robert Downey Jr. was in Weird Science? Oh gosh. I don't even remember that show. I remember I used to watch it, like, I'd seen a couple episodes a long time ago. But I don't remember the show. Mark Ruffalo. Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, him. I haven't seen the new Ninja Turtle movie, but someone told me they were gonna make the aliens. Was a show, movie, same thing. This run sucks. What is with these bad layouts? Hey, Hailmonger, how you doing?
Either way, I've seen it. Maybe my brain just remembers it as a show because I haven't seen it in forever.
I hear a lot of people really like the new Ninja Turtles. I haven't seen it. I haven't been interested in seeing it. Surviving? I'm doing okay. Also still in survivor mode, but doing okay. Doing definitely much better. Yeah, I hear Bebop and Rocksteady were done really well. Krang was a G. Now, was the first Ninja Turtle movie the one with Vanilla Ice in it, or was that the second one? These layouts suck so much. Just popped in to say hi. No, that's no problem. I'm glad you stopped in to say hi. It's very late, so definitely rest if you need to. I'm just glad to see you here. And hear that you're doing pretty well. Wow. What in the world? All right, Hellmonger, sleep well. Thank you for coming in. I should be back Monday or Tuesday. Sundays are no stream days for me. You out of here too, Soda? All right, man. I won't be here tomorrow since it's Sunday, but I'll be back Monday or Tuesday for sure. Glad to see you back as well. Glad to see everybody back. He was in the second one, okay. Who's Rami Malek? What is Mr. Robot? Did you know there's an entire movie with Vanilla Ice? Is it the most boring thing ever? You're working every day this week? Oh man, you're gonna be a very tired one. Good luck, Hellmonger. Hopefully the check will make up for you having to work every week. There's a shit piece here, so I need to find that like real quick. Yeah, I imagine so. No stream days. I don't ever want to hear you speak those words again. Well, you know. When I start my doctoral program, the first 6 months are like super duper mega intense. So there's a potential that I won't be streaming during that time. But we'll see. The check will be good, only thing keeping you going. No, that makes sense. Oh my gosh, why are these layouts so bad? These presents suck. All right, sleep well, man. Get lots of rest for tomorrow. Please let me cross there. Thank you. Stop zapping me. Cool as ice. He should have came out with a sequel called Flavorful as Vanilla. Trying to get in the habit of like not using my map at the beginning of every stage, but part of my brain still kind of rationalizes it as a decent idea because of the fact that you can see which way you're standing, where you are on the map, and which way might be the best way to go. So I need to decide what's the ultimate strat. Like, it's probably not worth doing overall. But it might be, I don't know. Like, the game is so random, so it's probably not worth, because of how random it is. The map could be wide open and it'll still put the elevator in the tiny corner just to spite you. What is that layout? Oh my gosh. That's nasty. This layout's so bad. Alright, so I jumped at an angle. You've got to be kidding me.
That was an angle jump.
Well, the problem with half of the resets has been because I haven't been getting ship pieces early. That's the main thing. And I can't tell that. I can't see the ship pieces on the map. So it's more just been the fact that they don't want to give me a ship piece until level 6. Yeah, I did mess up that one. Like, the only reset that's really sucked because of the map is the one where I got the glod, the 27 second glod. That would have been a good run, but it could have died like 4 stages later. You never know. So that's why it seems like it's not worth. Just because you really don't know. I mean, at the same time, it's also could be just inconsequential because it only takes like half a second. You know, if you do that over 25 stages and it takes, let's just say it takes 2 seconds because you accidentally hit A, so it pulls up the menu that tells you there's a ship piece or not, then that's a minute out of the entire run. So that's not so bad. So maybe it just doesn't matter. Okay, so there's the elevator. Now I just gotta find the ship piece. Like, see, I went up instead of down. The map wouldn't have mattered. Based on where I was, it was 50-50 either way. So in that case, it didn't matter if it was a waste of time for me to use the map in that case. Skyrim definitely kills it. I tried to do like a YouTube series for Skyrim, and it only lasted like 3 episodes because it just hurt too much. How far did I get? I can't even remember how far I got. I didn't fight anyone major. I think I visited like 2 or 3 towns, and then I was kind of in the woods in one spot. Like, I was just traveling as far north. Like, I would just set these weird spots on the map. It's like, I'm just gonna go here because that's what I want to do. And so my path was going north into whatever that mountain spot area was, and I just couldn't do it. I fought some bandits and I was on this waterfall and I just felt so sick. I had to turn off the game. So there's a shit piece here. This stage is huge, I can already tell. Which kind of sucks. There's a total conversion mod called Enderall. What's that? I can't even watch a YouTube video of it. Oh, there's a ship piece. I'm glad I pulled up the map. Holy crap. It's pretty in vogue. What's it do? Extra life is okay, whatever. That wastes like 5 seconds. Where's the elevator? $5 is fine. Yuck. Oh, I have Icarus wings. Okay. It's a massive mod. There's the elevator. Okay, this is good so far. This is good. If there's a ship piece on the next stage, then that would be amazing. False scar and worm's tooth. I don't know what those did. Well, I have money, so let's talk to this guy. If I can find the randomizer and get it out of the way, that would make this amazing. Please help. Randomizer me. Randomizer me. Randomizer. Randomizer. No. Why? Carrot man. Why didn't you manipulate the RNG to give me a randomizer? Please. Why am I not flying? I'm a dummy. There wasn't a ship piece here, though. Where are we? Alright, I'm gonna burn some high tops on stage 4 because it's huge. I need to cover a lot of ground. It basically turns Skyrim into another game, like a new Dungeons & Dragons campaign. Oh, that's pretty awesome. Yeah, let's not tempt fate with falling. Oh, hi Santa. Okay. I didn't mean to push A there. Alright, sweet elevator. It wasn't a terrible stage 4, it could have been a lot worse. So what's the plot of the Enderall mod?
TLDR, new land additions in general, and a whole bunch of new stuff.
So is the map bigger, or are they just adding new land spots in the map that currently exists, because they can't extend the map? No shit piece here. I'm just gonna follow the road for now. because the road likes to be nice with that sometimes. But it looks like it's going to be a... Never mind. I was going to say it looks like it's going to be a road troll, and it definitely was not. So that's good. I need more stages like that. I need a ship piece on this next stage. No, I don't. Not on stage 6. Stage 6 sucks. I need a fast stage 6 and then a ship piece on stage 7. And then a piece on stage 8. It's because I asked for it first. It gave me what I asked for first. Oh gosh. Oh no. I was hoping that wasn't a mailbox monster. New map. New game mechanics. Get off me. Crazy. Don't honk at all the boogeyman, dude. Okay, this is a road troll. This time. That sucks. Plot seems to revolve around a destined one. Interesting. Oh, there's a ship piece here. There's the ship piece. Okay, that's good. Hurry up. Let's go, let's go, let's go. I forgot about the ship piece. I was just looking for the elevator. Okay, so now the elevator is gonna be way over there. Doorway. No. Doorway.
Oh my gosh, please, why game? Why?
Being destined sucks. Apparently it makes you sick and you can die from it. That's pretty nuts. I need a doorway. Please. I don't need money. I don't need a book. I need a doorway. Oh my gosh, this is gonna kill me. I'm dead. Well, I found my unfall. I need a doorway, please. I'm getting all the bad stuff right now. This is terrible. Lightning, zap me. Zap me now. Oh. I mistimed it. This is so bad. That was such a terrible minute of present opening. Such a terrible minute. You'd simply get or discover the quest. Boo Bear, what is up? Long time no see. How have you been? So we have a ton of cash. I just need to identify like the randomizer again, because we found like 90% of the other presents. There was no ship piece, right? Okay, let's go. So this is still pretty good. We're still doing well. Hey, Beck said, okay, how you doing? If we can get a ship piece on this stage, that would be fine. That'd be nice. Nope. But if the elevator's right on the road, that would also be nice. Especially if I don't have to run past that gopher mole. Ah, crap. I'm gonna go this way. I'm doing pretty well. Thank you for asking. If I can get a PB tonight, that would be good. been better. You messed up your elbow like a month ago. Went to the chiropractor and he wanted you to get x-rays. Now you've been adjusted twice in a week. Your elbow is almost 100% better. Nice. That's good. Psycho, what is good, dude? How are you, man? I've been doing okay. Not too shabby. Things are picking up, so. I mean, there's always things I could complain about, but it's things are going so much better than they were that I'm not allowed to complain. Oh, gosh. There's the elevator. Okay, good. I'm glad I went up, because I almost went back down. I'm glad your elbow is doing better, Boo Bear. Oh, that's right. You're on graveyard schedule. I forgot about that, dude. How long have you been doing it for? The Buddha returns. I'm just trying to, I imagine my head on a Buddha statue. And it just looks funny. Was there a ship piece here? No pieces. Okay, let's just get out. Week two? Oh, okay, so yeah, you still got a little bit more time of adjustment to go. Oh, come on. If it's up in that top left corner, that's gonna suck. Sorry, I like a breeze, but lately you've just been randomly passing out. Ah, okay. Yeah. You're hitting that part of the phase of it? Yeah. I definitely understand that. I had a graveyard shift job in a fab once, which is like one of the most boring graveyard shifts jobs you can do. And it's also hard because it's one of those jobs where it's like, oh my gosh. Jerk. The environment is so specialized, like you have to actually really pay close attention. So you're not breaking motherboard chips. But at the same time, it's so boring and tiring that it's just hard to stay awake. Alright, so this whole stage just kind of sucks. You at work right now? Nice. Because it's like, you know, it's one of those controlled environments, so you have to wear the fab suits and all that. And you're basically transporting motherboard chips from one machine to the next for processing and creation. And so, you know, you gotta make sure there's no dust anywhere or anything like that. And the people who run the machines just kind of stand there and nap. Because it's like a 30-minute process and they're just standing there waiting on it to get done. While you're walking up and down the aisle constantly seeing if there's chips that need to go to another station. Yeah, it was a struggle to stay up for. I hated that job. Where is this elevator? This is really bad. It's probably in that one square in the middle that I didn't check. And I hate when the map trolls you like that. It's a sadness. Maybe it's over here, though. Okay, good. I guess I could have checked up here. Instead of going back around where I was at, I should have come up this way from the bottom right in the first place. So that was kind of my fault. I could have saved like a minute. Our presence power-ups? Kinda, in a sense. They have good things in them and they have bad things in them. So they can spawn bad guys, or it can be a total bummer and it'll just outright kill you. Unless you have a food present, you can like hold B to do like a small trick. Or it can give you money, or give you food, or give you rocket skates, or something helpful. Or it'll be a stupid randomizer, and randomize everything. Ever. Stage 10 is huge, but I just used the high tops on the last stage. Was there a present here? No. Okay, so what I'm gonna do... There's the total bummer I was just mentioning. So you hold B, use the food, it'll keep you from dying. There's the rocket skates I was hoping for. All right, let's go this way. I covered a lot of ground and didn't find anything. No! Man. Back on... Oh, come on. How far away from the thing am I? Because the thing is, the run's technically not quite dead yet. Just... mostly dead. Oh, that's a big run back. I have to burn a... Oh gosh. Alright, now it's dead. I couldn't make that jump. You played it.